Here we are at the Academy, where the Champaign will take on Miami here for a winner-takes-all, best of three. Winner does not take all, technically. Winner goes on into the finals, where they'll await their opponent. It might be Hamilton, it might not be, but that is later. Right now, six players looking to take on one another. Head-to-head, down at center ice for Slapshot Greatness. Who's it going to be? Will it be Champaign? Will it be Miami? The most coveted, one of the most coveted cups towards the lower side of the SPL. This is going to be a very even fight. I don't think that's a slight to say between these two teams. They've met each other twice during the regular season. Game one happening May 20th, 5-7. That score, Champaign came out on top later on in the season. Miami got the best of Champaign 6-5 on June 4th. It's been a few weeks since they've seen each other at center ice. Keep an eye on Kevin. Keep an eye on Afrenzik, as they are the goal scorers of the night. But of course, we'll get more into the depths. Let's take a look at the rosters before we get this one down and underway. Champaign, the visiting team tonight, finished the season 10-6-1, the second place team out of the Rockets Conference from the Prospect Division. Captained by Kevin, Tridoxity, Richard. Richard's a beautiful goaltender. I've never seen a man stop the puck with his amount of sacrifice since the likes of Rakitjaka back in season two of SPL. And I don't think any of you know who I'm talking about, but he held the record for most saves in a game out of any division in SPL for the longest time. I think it took 10 seasons before somebody bested his 26 saves in a single regular season match. Richard Tantrum, once again, one of the greats when it comes to the defensive game. Whether or not he's down there on the ice for Champaign, that's up for the captain to decide. Kevin, Richard, Darth Davin, and Tridoxity in the lobby here tonight for the Champaign. Don't see Axe. I remember playing Axe throughout the regular season. Both these teams coming out of my corner of the closet whenever it comes to the Prospect Division. I played both these teams twice. I don't want to play either of them again. They were a nightmare to me, myself, and I, and also my two other teammates. But they're playing against each other tonight, so it's not my problem. Afrenzik, the captain for the Miami Vice Academy. They finished 13-3-0, the top dogs out of the Rockets Conference in the Prospect Division. Followed along by Test and Zach for their starting lineup here tonight. It's sure to be a good one down at center ice at the Academy. Both these teams very acquainted with each other. Both these teams know what they're getting in for tonight. And before soon, I'm sure they're going to be getting into the lobby. Miami Vice Academy not in the lobby quite yet. But whenever they do come in, I'll be sure to let you know. We got the four for Champaign here tonight. They'll be wearing the green jersey on the left side of your screen. Attacking to the right, the Miami Vice Academy defending the right side in the Miami Vice black and pink. But both these teams got a lot of goal-scoring talent down there on the ice. They got a lot of goaltending status as well to go with it. Zach, the top goaltender for Miami, keep an eye on him to lay the puck up and start the breakout for the boys in pink here tonight. Afrenzik also having one of the more hefty sides as a one with possession time down there on the ice. 57 goals in his 15 games played throughout the regular season. It's going to be interesting to see how the Miami Vice really adapt to their opposition down there on the ice, as Richard knows how to stop the puck more times than not. But the starting three might just be Kevin, Tridoxity, and Richard. I would wager that to be the starting three, as Kevin, the captain, has played all 19 games throughout the regular season down in the Prospect Division at 109 points, 69 goals. Pretty nice. And 40 saves to go along with it. He plays a 200-foot game, and that will be called upon here tonight. As Axe joining the lobby for Champaign, they got all five players to pull from here tonight. The full roster on display. Axe is the second highest goal scorer for the Champaign, so it's good to see him in the lobby. Whatever lineup they stick out there on the ice, there's so many ways to mix and match their flavor palette here tonight. There's a lot of utility players on their roster. There's a lot of defensive talent. There's a lot of goal-scoring talent. And it's going to be a Rubik's Cube to solve here tonight. It's going to be about a game where the team that makes the best adaptations to their opponent is going to be the team that comes out on top. And whichever of these two teams can do it better is going to be the team in the finals. Of course, I think Miami is going to rely heavily on Afrenzik's ability to put the puck in the net, but can they get it to him without it being taken away is going to be the big qualifier down there on the ice. Out of all the goal scorers, out of all the teams in the Prospect Division, these two teams placing pretty high and mightily against their peers. Champaign being the fifth highest goal scorers out of the 14 teams we had in the Prospect Division, and the Miami Vice Academy not breaking 100 goals, but they are seventh in terms of the ballpark. They're right at the 500 mark, looking a little bit northways of it, as the Springfield Isotopes are just below them with two goals shy of what the Miami Vice had on their offensive output. So they don't score a lot, but when they do shoot, they do score. Their shooting percentage is one of the top dogs in the prospect division. Kevin, Richard, two of the starting for the Champaign Miami Vice Academy, having Zach Afrenzik and Tess join the lobby. So soon we will have our six to start this game. We're a few minutes past the start of the hour at a 9:30 start time. But, hey, it's the playoffs. Everybody wanted to take that few moments to keep themselves warm, keep themselves ready to go for whatever adversity they might see down there on the ice. Champaign starting lineup will be Kevin, Richard, and Axe, their two top goal scorers with their top goal saver. And the Miami Vice Academy having their top three starters that carried them throughout the regular season, gave themselves the best record in the Rocket Division, or the Rocket Conference of the Prospect Division. And we'll see which one of these teams might be taking on the opposite side of the bracket. Right now, the Hamilton Huskies and the Hamilton Boneyard Boys still have not set a game time for their match, as the Hamilton Huskies and the Toronto Horrors during the quarterfinals took a little few extra days. I think they played on Wednesday, if I'm not mistaken, yesterday for their round one matchup. Three days past the due date, so they are given a little bit more extra time for the Hamilton showdown on the other side of the bracket. But on this side of the bracket, Champaign during the first round took on the Kingston Kings, the wild card spot from the Beauties Conference, as the Beauties had the overall. Well, you can just show it on the bracket. Here, let me just pull this up real quick. This is what the prospect division looks like. We had two conferences, both of them starting with seven teams. Of course, the Michigan Mafia ended up dropping out after 2 weeks of the regular season. And so the Rockets Conference was dropped down to six teams. And so there was a game discrepancy between these two sides. Everybody plays their own conference twice. Everybody plays the opposing conference one time. So the Rockets Conference lost two games, whenever the Beauties Conference only lost one game per team. But that is all you need to know for this matchup. Six players are ready to rock. Six players are ready to roll it. We're taking it down to center ice at the Academy, where Miami Vice defend the right side in the black and pink. And on the left side, it's the Champaign in the green. I don't know why I thought Chicago. I saw the CHA. I immediately went to the Blackhawks, even though that's not their abbreviation. But either way, we're down on the ice. First period underway here in this best of three. If this is your first time watching an SPL playoff series, we play all three games. If needed, we'll just play two if it is a sweep in a single night. So we'll know who goes into the finals of the Prospect Cup before this final buzzer has concluded. Whether that's 30 minutes of slap shot or 45 minutes of slap shot, that's still to be determined. Good shot towards the cage there by Zach, just not quite able to hit it. Richard trying to keep that one down against the end wall. Nice stop there off that forensic shot from the point. That one's going to be cleared off to the near side. Zach looking topside for its test. Axe there forcing him to pass that one back to his defenseman. Zach looking near side for the Academy, going off the dome of Kevin, wearing a motorcycle helmet for a little bit of added protection here tonight. Does not want to walk away with a concussion here tonight, but a few goals in his back pocket. Kevin near side picking that one up in stride. Zach there playing a little offensive or back-checking pressure there. Friends, a great body. Lost over to Richard. Down low, Kevin with a chop towards Axe, but not able to hit him in stride. Test down low. Here's Zach with it at his own defensive yellow. On that back wall, guys looking down low. Zach to the near side, finding the captain Afrenzik here for the Miami Vice Academy. Zach near side, looking for Afrenzik yet again. The bank pass, not able to get that one through Richard. Richard keeping that one down low. Axe looking for the centering feed, going off his forehand. As that one bobbles free, Afrenzik going off the hands of Axe. Kevin trying to pull this one loose off the near side wall. Of course, the last few days, the East servers have not been happy. I don't know what happened during the pro semifinals night, the second game that we had between the Miami Vice A team, the Academy's pro counterpart, and the Astoria Hellhounds. There was difficulties left, right, and center. Hopefully we don't have any of that here tonight as the Prospect Division parties on. Kevin near side trying to drive this one out, going off the backhand of Zach, keeping that one down along his own near side corner. He pops that one back over to the top side. Test giving some elbow room. Zach giving leeway. Tess pulling this one for a near side pass towards Afrenzik, not able to hit him. Here's Kevin with it now. Looking top side over to Richard. Richard back over to Kevin. Kevin looking near side over to Axe. Axe off the backhand. Stopped there by Zach to the near side wall. Afrenzik here picking it up. If you're not sure which division we're watching right now, it's the Prospect Division. It is playoff mode. These are the top two teams out of the Rockets Conference. There are two conferences down in the Prospect Division. Prospect is the fourth out of five divisions in the ladder. So it goes open, prospect, then IM, challenger, and pro. Zach Picking this one up for Miami. Looks topside off the topside window, going off Tess, looking for the pass near side of Frenzik there, playing the backpedal game, playing safe rather than sorry. Tess getting a piece of that pass, goes over to Zach, topside. Handled out to the near side wall. Kevin getting a hand on that one. Picked up there by Test. Backhand shot saved away by Richard, keeping that one back out of the twine. Nobody able to pop that one through so far. Friends are getting a hand on that one. Test here looking for that shot lane to open up. Nice jive down the center, but not able to get that one away from Kevin. Good read on the defensive side for Champaign. Scoring off the backhand from his own defensive end. The first shot's a good one out there for the Champaign. Champaign. Axe over the great back pass. Kevin there tries to find that pocket, and he does. Test barely getting a lick of that one as it grazed by him. 1:52 to go here in the first. 1-0 our score. Going off Axe, almost able to find that one on the backhand. Hit the top side of his stick and skipped over him. Close, but not quite. Test bringing that one back over to Zach. Zach here with a 1:33 to go here in the first. Able to find its way back over to Test. Forehand pass. Kevin there steals it away from his hit. Backhand shot goes off Zach to the near side wall. Axe there keeping the cycle alive for the boys in green here tonight. Richard going off the hands of Test. Great takeaway there for the Academy. Backhand stopped there by Kevin. Going to dump this one down in favor of the Champaign. Zach near side along the wall. And Frenzik there picking up the mantle. Trying to find that forehand pass back to Zach, but it never came. Richard pulls that one back for the boys in green. Kevin here left alone with his own devices. Let's try to start this breakout on the right foot. Pops it past the hands of Test. Axe there looking for the return pass. A little give and go action. Used to be very prominent back in the slap one days. Test out in front. Finds a Frenzik and he scores off the forehand. Very dangerous spot to leave him all alone. With a 2-on-1. Kind of. It really wasn't a 2-on-1. A Frenzik just left alone to get that shot off. The 53 seconds to go here in the first. We're tied at ones here at the Academy. Shot made, going wide by Test. The Frenzik here keeping the cycle alive. Back out to the point here, Zach. Zach dangling back towards center. Axe there tries to force him towards that wall. Frenzik catching that on the dome. Got a shot on target technically. Here's Zach with a shot made. Nice block there by Kevin. Keeping that one down behind his own goal line. Kevin trying to find a passing lane to open up. Axe is the only one down ice. Zach's going to get a piece of that one. Directs that one wide of the cage, even if it was on. Wasn't. He was there anyway. 22 seconds to go. 1-1 still our score. Zach drives on. Finds a Frenzik after the bounce, perhaps. It's Richard there. Applies that pressure on the defensive side. Tries to find the pass down the straight. Doesn't like it. Elects topside over to Kevin. Kevin, backhand pass. Out of the reach of everybody. Goes down the full 200. Zach, the first man to it for Miami. 6 seconds remain in the first of game one. The Frenzik, a great body position. Kevin going to dump it down. We end the first. 1-1. Nobody with the lead here on Miami's home turf. So we continue the quest for the Prospect Cup Finals. One shot, one goal. Champaign hitting 1,000 so far here tonight. They've saved the majority. 3 saves out of the total 4 call to arms out there for the Champaign's defense. Of course, Richard, once again, doing his due diligence to keep that biscuit out of the oven here tonight. 3 of the team's 3 saves. Kevin with the lone goal from his own side of the ice. Frenzik giving a silver platter for a goal there in that first period. 3 shots on the attempt. 1 goal to show for it, and hey, that's all you really need. Second period's ready to rock. Second period is ready to roll. Champaign not making any changes like what they saw during that first period of action, so we'll see more of that here in the second. The puck is dropped. The game is on. Champaign defend left in green. Miami defends right in black. Of course, Champaign do have both of their subs in the lobby here tonight if Darth Avon or my mind has already slipped his name, Tridoxity. If they want to play either of them, they can sub them in during the intermissions, or if somebody's power goes out, they can come in on the fly, but whoever subs out cannot come back into play until the next stoppage of play, whether that's first, second, intermission, or the end of the game. Zach picking this one up off the backhand, sent down the straight, goes off Kevin with a backhand shot. Now it's going to go in off the topside post. And the Champaign, for the first time tonight, are on top with a 2-1 game. The captain leading the charge here in terms of offense. Might not be in the ozone, but they're hitting the net where it counts. 31 seconds into the second. The Champaign are first to strike iron here in the second. Test picking it up near side. Richard almost able to pick that one off. Good stop there by Zach, getting awarded a save in the process. The technical first save Miami's made here tonight against the Champaign. Kevin here picking it up. Looks for the backhand feed over towards Richard. Zach there getting a hand on that one. Axe goes off Test. Test here with body position. Finds it down low for Miami. Frenzik there with a hard angle shot. Not able to make it work for him. Here's Axe off the backhand. Looks to lead that one to Richard. Not quite on the same page there. Frenzik, Zach, near side Test. Pulling this one back top side. Tries to get it down low for Zach. Zach doesn't like it. He's just going to say, all right, let's start the back check. Cut our losses. We're playing ball. Here's Zach. Forehand shot goes off the curve of the blade of Kevin as he directs it to the near side corner. Richard there tries to get it down the near side wall, but not able to get that one to work with him cleanly as he pokes off the wall. Unfortunately, shot made, and they score, and it's 2-2. And the Academy able to find a way to get an answer on the board. You get enough pressure in the offensive zone, eventually good things will happen. And so far here tonight, Miami's done a heck of a job of keeping that puck down low. Test off the backhand, sent to the near side wall. Goes off the tip of the blade of that forensic as Axe keeps that one down in favor of Champaign. Kevin back to Richard, near side looking for Axe. He looks to peel this one off the near side wall, sporting the five on the back of his jersey. Looks and sends that one down to the far side wall. Test picking it up. Looks near side to Afrenzik. Afrenzik looking for a way to get it out in front. Nice stop there by Richard. Sends it back to the neutral zone. Axe and Zach do battle at center ice. Puck bobbles loose over to Afrenzik. Afrenzik centering feed. Going off the hip of Axe back to the point. Test here picking it up for Miami. Red line. Nice shot. He scores right from the point. Long distance shot with a laser connection with 2:54 to go here in the second period. Test able to put his team back in the lead. Five goals being scored so far here tonight. Only one separates them now. Afrenzik from the red line. Looks topside. Axe takes it away. Shooting! Far side post. And that one's going to be cleared out of the danger lane there by Zach. Test brought back at his own defensive end wall. Zach here starting the charge once again. He may be blindfolded, but he's one with the force, and the force is with him. Afrenzik back to Zach. Axe getting a hand on this one as he chops this one down low. Test here picking it up. Also blindfolded. Half the team for Miami not able to see the puck, but they can feel it. Can guarantee you that much. Adam Tantrum goes topside, going off the topside window, down into the O-zone for the Champaign. Zach here picking it up at Frenzik there, bobbles it, goes over to Richard. Richard looking down low, push him around. Zach near side wall, at Frenzik picks it up, off the back end, drives in. Richard getting this one down low. Hops this one back out to the neutral zone, goes past Axe, test over to Zach. Zach looking down, not able to find the shot on target. Kevin with a lob towards the cage, not able to get it to go neither. Zach near side for Miami. Afrenzik doesn't like where he's at. Gives it back over to Zach. Zach giving some leeway. Goes topside against the wall. Kevin quick to the pressure of Test's puck possession. Goes off Afrenzik out into the point. Not able to find a scoring opportunity there from Kevin as that one goes wide. Afrenzik here trying to find a way to get a passing lane opened up. Zach just hugging the topside post. Test there clears it into the corner. Test off the backhand. Sent to the near side wall. Goes off the body. Frenzik not able to make contact with it. Richard down low, corner to corner, back over to Kevin. The captain here for Champaign looking near side, just out of the reach. Have Frenzik on the pickoff. Axe going to battle it out in the near side corner in the O zone. Goes off the side of the cage. Frenzik there with the clear out. Hits Richard on the way through. Axe there with a catch. Nice stop there by Zach. That one cleared out. Nitz goes into the back of the twine to the Champaign end. 1:10 to go. Two goals now. The gap. Frenzik able to find the back of the twine here at the red line. Long distance shot with a solid connection. That gap has grown to two. Zach pulling that one to the top side. Test there with a return fire back over to Zach. 60 seconds remain. Zach at Frenzik goes off Richard. Zach here with a now forehand shot. A little lag touch there. The server just did not want that shot to go through, so it didn't. Hockey god Jeremy has a way of doing work. A stop there by Kevin as he sends it off to the near side wall. Zach here picking it up, goes off the wall. Kevin back to Zach. Passing it around like it's a little hot potato. I don't want it, you take it. No, I don't want it, you take it. Kevin, top side, able to find his way through over to Richard. Richard going to have to trail after it. Zach picking it up with 30. Top side, here's Test for Miami. Back to Zach behind his own goal line. Near side off the wall. Goes off the hip of Afrenzik. Going to chase after it. Richard, better body position, finds his way back over to Kevin. Kevin here for the Champaign. Off the backhand feed, fighting Richard off the near side point. Backhand pass in the air. Axe going to throw that one back out to the point. All the way down into his own defensive end. Kevin with 10 seconds remaining. Afrenzik looking for the forehand shot. Never got the angle on it. Good pressure there by Kevin on the back check. Afrenzik shooting far side and wide into the corner. Stess going to ring that one down corner to corner. And that's the end of the second. Four for Miami, two for Champaign here at the Academy. Both teams slugging it out. Both teams getting shots wherever they can take them. Somehow the block shots are in the 30s. 35 to be exact, because I can do math, at least at a third grade level. 35 blocks. Where do they all come from? I don't know. It's a handsome number. No saves during that second period from Richard. Very surprising. Did get a shot off, though. Kevin with an extra goal there in that second period for the Champaign. Of course, our Forensic picking up a few tallies for his goal scoring column there in that second period. Zach also finding the board with 11 takeaways, 11 turnovers. People say the takeaway ratio is a little bit scuffed in terms of slap shot, but I mean, Zach has done God's work on both sides of the puck. I mean, he's not giving the puck up more than he's taking it, so that's saying something for you. But everyone's ready to rock, everyone's ready to roll. Keeping the same six on the ice to start the third that started the first. We'll see what history has to tell us here and now. Miami on the right side in the black, Chicago, or the Champaign on the left side in the green. I'll get it right at some point here tonight, just won't be right now. 5 minutes remain here in game one. Whoever has the lead at the end of this timer will move on into game two with an opportunity. Tridoxity is subbing in. I completely lost sight of that. Richard, nowhere to be found. Tridoxity takes to the ice, hoping for a little extra added offensive output by this change for the Champaign. Tridoxity near side, finding his way off Kevin. Axe there just pushing it on towards the cage. Axe is a hard man to move with the stick, I'll tell you what, firsthand. Tess taking this one down to the near side, finding the puck in his favor. Has a lot of elbow room to work with. Off the back end, waited a little bit too long. Axe getting a piece of that one. Tridoxity coming back for it, trying to get this one down the near side wall, back behind his own goal line. And he'll do so softly and slowly. But Kevin, able to come back for it. Put it topside down the wall, chips it over the top of the stick of Test. Accident like that one. Let's take this one back for pristine positioning. Puck possession. Zach. Going to make this one 5-2 here with this next drive. A Forensic. Challenge there by Kevin. Forced to take this one back for a moment. Tridoxity, great takeaway. Not able to make it work with him, though. Out in front, Test there. Able to get a piece of that one. Sent off to the far side wall, keeping that one out of the blue paint of the defensive end. Nice drive there by Tridoxity. Not able to get that one in between the pipes. Good save there from Miami. The real first time, I think, tonight they've been tested on the defensive end. It was then and there. Axe there takes it up off the back end, trying to find the shot lane to open up. Not able to find it. Zach there stops him promptly at the faceoff circle. Second time there by Test. Test topside down the straight. Zach here picks it up. Backhand, forehand, shot made off the side of the cage. Here's Kevin. Able to find Axe. Backhand pass down low. Finding its way over to Tridoxity. Back to the point. Here's Kevin. From the red line. Shot made. Blocked there by Zach into the far side wall. He plinks of the puck around, goes off Kevin's stick, not able to find that one to ring true. Tridoxity just playing the physical game, wearing the Blackhawks hat, finding his way back to the near side wall. Test there, knocking it loose. Tridoxity here down low in the O zone, trying to get this one back to the point. Kevin there helping it out off the backhand pocket. Tridoxity here with lone possession. Backhand shooting, scoring! Top shelf where you keep the peanut butter, and it's 3-4. We're back within one with 2:45 to go here in the second. He looks shocked, utter horror down there on the ice. You saw it in his eyes. He can't believe what he just did. Test, Kevin. Looking near side to get this one down low. No, Bengal, the reason the blocks are so high is because the way that blocks are calculated was changed entirely. Normally we'd have at most 13 blocks in a game, even in a best of three series. We would see sometimes 13 blocks in an entire series. But things have changed. Sorry, I was sneezing. What a shot. 4-4 on the board. 2:15 to go here in the third period of action. Axe able to serve it up on a silver platter. Tridoxity, great shot, great spot, great goal. We're tied at fours. Here's Zach with it now. Bangs it off the top side glass. Back over to Tridoxity. Towards Axe. Going to leave that one leak into the corner. Here's Zach with it now for Miami. Zach near side, a Forensic picking it up off the forehand. Backhand, drives down the near side wall. Backhand, chip towards the cage, goes wide. Here's Kevin with sole possession of the puck. Off the backhand, would have been on. Great block there by Zach at his own blue line. A Forensic here battles it loose on the top side wall, leaves it for Zach after a moment. Good leading pass there to its Test. Test, from the point, gets fancy with it. Tridoxity given an opportunity to get in there with a few stick checks. Kevin there tries to get it down the near side wall. Out in front, nice stop there by Accents to the far side wall. Test there, gets it back to the point. Zach trying to knock that one loose back over to Forensic. Here's the captain of Miami looking topside off the wall. Zach getting a hand on this one. Backhand shot. Nice stop there by Kevin. Kevin here with a buck 20 to go here in the third. Next goal probably going to be. I don't know. It might happen. It came out of my mouth as soon as the shot was released. Forensic, great shot from his own side of the red line. And, hey, if he can hit it, might as well take advantage. 1:18 to go here in the third. Nine goals into it. One's the gap. Kevin topside, Tradoxity near side, stolen by Afrensic. Backhand shot goes off Kevin. Test there, picks it up at the blue line. Gets past one, but not Kevin. Afrensic with a shot. Nice block there by Kevin. Shot into the far side wall. Down low in the corner. 60 seconds remain. Test here with the puck now. Has the lead. Not in a rush to get this one down and turned over. Tradoxity, great stick check. Kevin there leads the charge near side. Off the back end. Pauling shooting. Stopped there by Zach and sent out the other way. 48 and ticking. Tradoxity to Kevin. Kevin off the back end. Losing ground to a Afrensic, sent to the near side wall. Tradoxity from the corner, sends it back over to Kevin. Kevin there bobbled it for a moment, not quite the puck touch he wanted. Goes off test tip. Tradoxity down into the corner of Afrensic. Afrensic here for Miami. Gonna just wait it out. Kevin there doesn't like it. Backhand shot towards the cage. Nice stop there by Test, sent down the straight. Goes off the hands of Kevin. Kevin shooting, post, and Axe able to put it away. Fives on the board. We're back tied up like a hog in a rodeo. Kevin off the post, the heartbreak almost left by the wayside, but Axe able to capitalize in a big way there. 23 seconds to go. Next goal has to be the one to seal the deal, right? It has to be. Kevin with a shot, Zach there with a stop. Axe here trying to pick up the mantle off the back end. Shot blocked away there by Test on the far side faceoff circle. Zach going to get it out of the way of harm. Kevin getting a piece of that. Afrensic here trying to drive on. Kevin there chops it towards Axe, not able to find his back of the blade. Zach's near side. Test here pulls it back around. We have overtime. Indefinite amount of time. Next goal wins it. And they take sole possession of game one in a big step towards the final appearance. And that's going to do it immediately from the drop of the puck. Only 4 seconds elapsing in overtime. Afrensic able to find a shot lane on the near side. Gets it past Axe. Gets it past Tradoxity. And that will do it for game one. It's fallen out Miami's way so far here tonight. We'll see if the series continues that way or if we have another story to tell before the night's over. 12 shots, 6 goals on the board. What a game that was. After Richard left the ice, he played a great first period. He had 3 out of the team's 3 saves. At that second period, a little lackluster from his own side of the ice. The team pulled him out. Tradoxity leaving the lobby. Darth Avon going to be playing for the Champaign here in the second game. Trid and Rich are both restarting their game to try to get better lag. So, that's the word from Kevin, the Champaign captain. So now everybody at home also knows. Kevin, 2 goals. Tradoxity, 2 goals. Tradoxity only played, what, 1 period. It was in the third. He found himself a double up there on the board. But Champaign going through a little bit of lag, perhaps, the word on the street. Of course, Afrensic, the golden goal in overtime, had 4 of on the night so far here in their playoff run. Miami Vice Academy already having a first round bye. This is their first playoff game here in the postseason of season 13. So they're getting their feet wet, and you can't ask for a better outcome if you're a Miami Vice Academy fan. First game into it, you're undefeated, looking to make it 2 in a row, going to the finals on a high horse, on a high note, in a good way. We'll see if they can hold it together, hold down the fort, and get her going. As we're down here at ice level, it was absolutely electric. Getting to talk to a few people down around the rink. They were expressing their appreciation to the Miami Vice Academy and the Miami Vice's A-team, as the coaching has been phenomenal throughout the regular season. The on-ice skates, the locker room presence that the A-team has provided them, with Reno at the helm of the general manager position for both the A and the B team. Of course, Afrensic, the standing captain of the Miami Vice Academy, had a lot of good things to say with the management of the franchise, of the org, and hopefully we get to see more good things come from them. I'm really excited to see if the Miami Vice Academy have the dedication and the prowess to get up into IM. I'd love to see them up with the bigger boys, so to speak. But we'll just have to wait and see what really happens at the end of the next few 15 minutes. At the end of the next 15, there's a chance that it'll be the end of the series, but there's also the equal amount of chance, I would wager, that we do have ourselves a bigger and better game. But we'll take a short ad break, and we'll be right back here whenever ready to go here on the SPL Network. I say that for the average everyday viewer, nothing is happening. That's just we're just hanging out. But I do need to play ads, because if I don't, there will be, in the middle of like the third period, we will find ourselves one. For some reason, Twitch didn't take the first ad break of the stream seriously, and so everything's messed up with the ad schedule. But hopefully this also disables the pre-roll ads for everybody else. But thank you for hanging out. Thank you for bearing with me. But 10 shots to 12, the gap on the board possession time, 250 to 148. Good stuff from both sides of the ice. Hanging out. They know. They know for a fact that the team with the majority of possession time is the team that controls the dictation of the play. And once again, they're challenging the shots early. We're getting a lot of blocked shots. Even after the update, I think this is a decent amount of blocked shots. Both teams are challenging the shooter right off the bat. Not a lot of pucks are even being considered a possibility when it comes to saves made. And so, of course, tonight, the defense is key. As we saw prominently during that first game, the saves is what kept the teams in it. Miami really wasn't truly tested until that third period, so this next game is going to be a big step in the right direction. Kevin, Darth, Davin, Tridoxity going to be the starting three for the Champaign. Zach, a forensic test, going to be the starting three for the Miami Vice Academy. Yeah. I don't have much else for you. The takeaways. We can talk about the takeaways a little bit. This will be the first game I think Darth Davin's played since for a while. It has been a hot second since Darth Davin has stepped foot on SPL ice. He played 5 games throughout the regular season, had 18 points to show for it during his drawn-out battles down in the prospect division. And we'll see what he's got. He's going to be starting this second game, getting his feet wet onto SPL playoff ice. I think it's the first time in his career that we will see him down there on the ice. And it's only a matter of time until we see this come to fruition. If you did redeem VIP, I will get it after the stream. I have to do that personally because I don't know why. They just will not let mods assign VIP, so I'm sorry for that. I don't even know if you can hear me right now. You're not subbed. So are you really a VIP? I don't know. I'm just teasing. But, yeah, it looks like both sides are ready to rock, ready to roll. The ads are done. We're back down on the ice at the Academy. We're looking to get this one down in actionable lickety split. On the right side of the screen, it's the Miami Vice Academy in the black and pink. On the right side of the screen, it is the Champaign in the green. Zach looking down towards that near side wall. Forensic there chopping it into the zone. Tridoxity. And this one out and around town. And towards that top side for an opportunity down the straight. Good stop there by Forensic. Opening up that opportunity with a few stick checks of his own. Finds his way near side. Darth Davin getting shot out of the way there by Zach. Zach looking top side. Test. Pulling this one back out and around town. Zach. Off the back. It's stopped there by Trid. Trid here with a backhander. Looking for that shot lane. Maybe a leading pass there for Darth Davin. Not able to find him. Here's that forensic out of the zone. Driving on. No opposition. Forehand shot goes wide off the far side. Test there with a cycle back over to Zach. Zach at his own blue line. Sent to the near side wall. Forensic there trying to get this one down low for Test for a through pass. But Kevin meets it first. Goes off Davin. Forensic there pulls it top side against the wall. Going to back pass this one over to Test. Test to Zach. Zach waiting for a man to get open. Near side. Finds it off the wall. Forensic there. Back pass over to Zach. Zach in trouble. The last man back. A double challenge. Shot made. Hits the post. Test there. Clears it off to the near side wall. Test. Trying to get this one through. Helping along is Zach. A forensic there with a great block. Sending this one down the near side wall. Zach here backhand shooting. Scoring. And the first on the board are the Miami Vice Academy. 1-0. 3:46 to go here in the first. Great shot there by Zach. Barely able to whiz that one past the left side of Kevin. Or I guess it'd be Kevin's right side, our left side. Either way. Potato, tomato. The forensic. Looking off towards that near side. Off the forehand, backhand. Getting a hand on this one is Tridoxity. Able to get this one out of the zone. Caught there by Zach in the neutral zone. Sent topside. A lot of elbow room here for Test. Test trying to fake him out. Tridoxity there staying on a shot lane. Goes off the body to Afrenzik. Not able to get the shot to release. Maybe a little bit of lag. Maybe not. We'll give him the benefit of the doubt and say yes. Zach going off that backhand. Looking down low. Test here with it now at his own end wall. Test with nobody to pass to except towards that near side. Zach here picking it up. Has either wall to go with. Goes topside over to Test. Test there doesn't like his options. Goes over to Zach. Zach looking near side. Cuts it across the grain. Kevin getting a piece of that one. Test there with body position. Good slap of the stick there by Darth Davin. Goes over to Kevin. Darth back out to Tridoxity. Shooting! That one's blocked away there. And that's the first technical shot from the Champaign here tonight in Game 2. Way earlier on than in Game 1. They didn't have their first official save until the midsection of the second period. So the fact that the Champaign are already able to find a challenge to the Miami Vice defense is a testament They're adapting. They're looking to overcome. Kevin, off the backhand, stopped there by Tess. Tess with a shot, immediately deflected there by Kevin. Goes off the body of Davin on the hip check against Tess, knocking that puck loose against the Miami back wall. Efrenzik here, the standing captain, losing that battle, goes over to Trudoxity. Trudoxity, backhand, trying to find that jive down the near side wall. Will not take no for an answer. Nice shot, better save there by Zach, taking this one out towards that top side. Finds his way to Tess. Tess off the back end, wants that shot lane to open up. Trudoxity not giving him anything easy to work with. Kevin there dumping it down. Here's Zach with the puck now. Bobbled against the wall. Tess to the near side. Leads that one for Efrenzik. Efrenzik trying to get past Kevin with a back pass for the Champaign. Back to Trudoxity. Trudoxity off the top side window. Finds Davin leading past Kevin. Catching it. Goes off Efrenzik. So they battle it out. Miami comes out on top. Davin there. Quick with the back checking challenge. Efrenzik there. Finds himself some elbow room. Trying for the back pass to Zach. Either of them on the same page there. Trudoxity near side. Going to chop that one back down to the defensive end. 1:34 to go here in the first. Here's Kevin. Leading past Davin, catching it. Would have had a shot. That would have been perfectly on target. Test there with a great block. Right in position. Ready for it. Kevin. Back pass softly to Trudoxity. Has some elbow room to work with. Two passing lanes to open. Test there taking it away on the far side attempt. Goes corner to corner, near side to his captain. Efrenzik gets past Kevin. Efrenzik, top side to Test. Back to the point. Back in. Down low. Almost able to find Efrenzik. And he does. He finds a way to muscle it loose. After the catch from the release of the shot from the point. Somehow found it right on the curve of his blade. The backhand shot rings true. 109 to go here in the first, and it's 2-0 Miami. Seconds to go. Efrenzik there blocking that one away. And down this near side wall. Backhand pass. Zach there keeps it low. Test here. Polling. Shooting. Not able to get it in. Zaun comes back out into the neutral zone. Good stop there by the Champaign defense. Trudoxity on the near side wall, finding his way to the point. Darth goes topside over to Kevin. Kevin backhand shot goes off Zach. Trudoxity out in front, stopped there by Efrenzik. Trudoxity knocks it loose, looks for the centering feed. Zach there with a save. If he didn't save that rebound and keep it in his own control, Davin would have tucked that one to bed. Kevin, forehand, topside. Leading Trudoxity for a challenging stick match. Good read there by Davin. Centering feed in the air. Back to the point. Here's Kevin. Kevin off the blade of Efrenzik. That one's going to be centered back over to Test. Looking down low. Here's Zach. Zach, backhand feed. Kevin picks it up. Off the backhand shot. Goes off the body. Darth Davin almost able to find a way to crack that Rubik's Cube. Find himself a solution down there. That will do for the first period of action. 2-0 on the board. The Miami Vice Academy able to find themselves on top so far here tonight. Both teams playing their hearts out. Only one team able to find a score so far here at the end of the first 5 minutes. Five shots for the Champaign, all of them being answered down there on the ice for the Miami Vice Academy. Four shots on target, two of them going in. Richard being called in spot of Davin. Axe going to remain on the bench for the Champaign. Of course, there's only three in the lobby for Miami, so they'll stick with their guns, see where it leads them. One save for Kevin, one save Davin for the total of two at the end of one. On the other side of the ice, Efrenzik, Zach both getting one goal apiece for the Miami 2. Four of the team's five saves. Zach handling it very nicely. Six ready to rock, six ready to roll. We're back down on the ice here for the second of the second game of the series. Miami Vice Academy on the right side in the black. Champaign, Champaign on the left side in the green. Efrenzik back over to Zach. Zach looking near side with Richard back on the ice. I really hope that frees up Kevin. Kevin's the top goal scorer for the Champaign. He's looking at the stat lines. He looks like he leads as a one. And I think he needs to get back to playing that. I feel a little bit worse picking apart their game plan because I'm in this division. It feels more like a personal attack. I promise it's not. It's just from professionality. It's just my opinion. Man. I think Kevin just needs to get the puck more, getting it in a shooting opportunity. Get it in the ozone. Kevin led goal scoring last game. I don't know. Oh, Efrenzik with an empty net. Great takeaway, great read on the play. Read it like a Dr. Seuss book. Five shots on the board, three of them going in for the Miami Vice Academy. Nobody back to tell them no. Richard playing with his cards on the table with that one. And that one's going to sting for a while. But I feel like the key to victory right now for the Champaign is let Richard play the goalie. Give him an opportunity to pass it on both sides, both boards going down the ice. And if you're covered, take a few steps back. I feel like that's the key to victory right now. Great leading pass to Tradoxity. Not able to outbump Zach, though. Kevin left alone with the puck. Has two lanes to go, forward and backwards. So he gets this one down over to its test. Looks down this near side wall, goes off at Frenzik. Here's Kevin with it now. Kevin, off the backhand. Wanting to get this one down the far side straight, finds Tradoxity. Off the red line, test takes it away, goes off at Frenzik to the near side wall. Richard, bank pass down low. Here's Kevin. Kevin, leading pass. Richard, top side, looking for Tradoxity down the straight. Tradoxity somehow wasn't challenged by the stick of test. I'm surprised. Whenever I see that opportunity, I just assume whoever the defenseman is just going to Beyblade and let whatever hits. Tradoxity back at the blue line, looking to break this one downtown. Gets it off the wall. Test there, staying in the shot lane to keep that one wide. And Frenzik against Richard, leaves it alone for Kevin. Kevin here, the captain of Champaign, looks top side, finding its way to Tradoxity. Tradoxity, shot made, goes off Zach on the far side, faceoff dot. That one goes in off the defense. Give us a little top-down view. And that's just a big bag of unfortunate. Champaign on the board here in the midsection of the second. Just a little bit over. 2 minutes elapsing here in the second period of action. A little bit of fortune smiling on them here tonight, and they needed that. You gotta start a crack in the dam before it breaks loose. You know what I'm saying? Two goals the gap. One step at a time. Tradoxity, backhand, shot made, end of the rebound, not able to go in. Good defense there, just barely saving it away. Kevin able to find the rebound out in front. Great pass there by Tradoxity. All alone, down low. It's Test trailing him a little too far gone. And Tradoxity wearing the Blackhawks jacket, putting pride on the banner. 2 minutes, 33 seconds remain in the second. One goal is the gap now. Kevin lobbing it down low. Bank pass off the end wall to Tradoxity. Now Frenzik looks near side. Zach pulling this one off the forehand. I see Rodeo in the Twitch chat. We're having a great day. Pulling it down. Smart hockey. It's a Champaign way. Miami way. They're both really holding it down, actually. Now that I'm thinking about it more, they're both playing a spectacular defensive game. That neutral zone could be worked on a little bit, though. I could feel it. I feel like most sides, I've done this a long time. I need you to understand this. I've never seen the Plinko Machine of Majesty happen down at center ice before in my life. I've never once seen that puck go out of play outside of a faceoff drop. That's wild to me. That is a first. I've had a long career. I've seen pucks go over the net back before it wasn't possible. I've seen pain handles from a pass from the defensive side for a 200-foot goal. Never once have I seen that. My goodness. Zach picking it up down this near side. Looking for that wrap towards the top. It's Test. Looking back on the defensive side. Something I was saying earlier, it comes down to the bumping game. Who can win the majority of bumping battles? Who can have the better takeaway ratio? I think wins the majority of slapshot games. I don't have the stats or like the methodical backing to like back that up. That's what my heart tells me. And like 50% of the time, my heart's right, which is a passing grade in some countries. Great shot there. Better block by the Miami defense. Some comes all the way back down to the Champaign end. 48 seconds to go here in the second. One goal still separates them in favor of Miami. Tradoxity back to Richard. Richard. Looking for that leading pass. Test there, taking it away. Tradoxity there, fights it, frees it. Goes over to Kevin. Kevin, one man to beat. Not able to find the backhand hook on target. Goes topside and wide. He cycles it back out towards his own defensive end. Here's Richard. Richard lobbing it down low. Kevin almost had the stick position to catch it. Zach there lobs it back out neutral. Here's Richard keeping it down to the near side. Finding its way off Tradoxity. Drives it on. Zach with a save. And Tradoxity not able to find that one through. This comes all the way back down into the Champaign end. Champaign have the Miami Vice Academy on the back pedal right now. Can they capitalize on it before the momentum fizzles out? Richard. Backhand, chop, stop by Test. Test, polling, shooting, far side and wide. That's a heartbreaker. Oh, man. 5 goals have been scored here tonight at the Academy. Here in Game 2, Champaign 2, Miami 3 at the end of the second. It looks like we might see Axe here for this one. Richard, of course, having a bit of a ping issue during that first game. Alleged as the captain of the Champaign spoke up at the end of the game. Both players, Axe and Richard, restarting their game. Hoping that it gives them better ping during that second period. Richard getting one takeaway. Never turn the puck over. Good passing game from him. 8 shots by Tradoxity. He's the rock they're going to have to lean on, and he will not be in this third period. X, Kevin, Richard, the starting three here for the third. Playing with their full lineup here for the second game, throwing everything at the wall, seeing what sticks. They just need one to tie it with Miami. They need two to win it. And it's prolong this series into a game three, which anything can happen in a game three. Forensic two goals, Zach with one for the total of 3 and 6 out of the team's 8 saves coming off the face, the body, and the sacrifice of Zach so far. Both sides having the majority. There really isn't that much of a difference between any of these stats. Miami has been on the back pedal for the most part here. 22 blocked shots needed, 8 saves to be had. And an immense amount of shot attempts there from the Champaign between their posts hit and their blocked shots. I think it's really only 2 posts hit. I don't show it anymore, even though I think I should bring that back. I think it's a much more funny stat to show. It feels a little demeaning, but I like the thought of keeping track and pointing out how many posts have been hit during a game. But maybe later. Maybe later. But Tridoxity said it in Twitch chat earlier here tonight that he's playing on 80 ping. And so as we're back down here at ice level, getting up close and personal with the rink, getting to smell the fumes of the game. It might not all be pleasant smelling, but hey, whatever gets you going. Tridoxity says restarting the router. Zach's lone man not ready up for Miami. He's the only one we're really waiting on here tonight. Yeah. Would you create the scene? It's great. I made it over the weekend. I got bored. I'm like, I need more than just the studio. I want more. I want to be able to do more stuff. I hope that I can figure out Blender's animations, because I can do so much with animations. There could be people back there skating around, hanging out, having a good time. But there's not. Not yet. Not yet, anyway. But hopefully one day. But 6 players ready to rock. 6 players ready to roll as they're coming out of the tunnel. We'll get this one underway here in the third period of game 2. Miami Vice with a win will end out the series and find themselves in the finals. Miami Vice will be defending the right side in the black jerseys. Champaign on the left side in the green. Champaign need this win to prolong this series and find themselves an extra 5 minutes at least to get themselves back in the rodeo. Axe topside. This is the original Champaign roster. This is the original boys that started this group here tonight. Looking to end out season 13 with the OGs. I respect this immensely. Top 2 goal scorers and the top save maker down there on the ice. Kevin, leading goal scorer for the Champaign. Axe closely in second. Nice shot there by Axe, just barely wide off that far side. But the East servers have been brutal recently. I don't know what it's been for the North American East servers. During the pro semifinals, the server kicked multiple people out. We had Zesh just lose his router entirely. I don't know if that was Slapshot related, but I choose to believe it was. And at the same time, the Oceanic Slapshot servers went down twice during that series. I don't know if it has anything in correlation with each other with how the back-end services work, because I'm not a technician. But hey, Zach able to find a goal. Puts his team up by 2 here in the third period. 58 seconds elapsing off that clock. Great pass by Tess. Great pull and a shot. Thereby, Zach able to find its way past 2 Champaign players, and that's going to be a hard bullet to bite, but they got to grit their teeth. They got to play with the cards they're given. It's now or never, and it's do or die for the Champaign. Richard, one man to pass to down the ice, and it's Axe. Axe pulls it away, wearing the big 5 on the back of his jersey. Zach finding that puck on his favor. Kevin trying to slap that one away from Afrenzik. Afrenzik here down low in the enemy zone. Takes it off that back wall, pass out to the neutral zone. Zach here having the trail after it. Near side faceoff circle. Axe there forcing the issue. Test there takes it back on the defensive side. Here's Zach. Zach looks topside. Banked off the glass. Kevin there picking that one off his front window. The motorcycle helmet. Is he wearing glasses as well? I think he might be. Richard topside. Kevin back down low. Here's Richard with an out. I need Kevin to score so I can do like a close-up angle. I need to know. This is the questions I need answers for right now. 3:12 to go here in the third. 2 goals the gap. Here's Zach with the puck now. Trying to find any passing lane to open up. Could have brought it back down around town for Afrenzik, but elected not to. He's trying to drive it out with just sheer ferocity and his stick-checking ability. He gets this one down the full length of the ice and lets his boys go chase after it. Here's Richard, near side, finds Axe. Backhand, pulling, shooting off the backhand of Zach and wide. Kevin, what a shot there by Axe. Would have been on if not for the hip check out of the top of the crease by Zach. Back topside, here's Test. Down to the near side, empty cage. Afrenzik with a through pass. Doesn't take the shot. Not sure if charitable or if he was just really nervous. Because I've been both before, and I don't know how to read that one. Nice shot, Richard, getting a piece of that one, sending this one to the near side wall. Cuts it across to Kevin. Zach here picking it up, goes off at Forensic. Here's Tess with it now. Tess for the Miami Vice Academy. Challenged there by Kevin's backhand stick check. Knock loose into the corner. Zach, Test, back to Zach. Top side to Test. Test, pulling, near side. Axe there, takes it away. Kevin, pull, shoots. Nice save there by Zach, and that was sent down off the rebound of Axe. Kevin, down in the near side corner, forcing that one towards that top side of the ice. Zach doesn't like it. Goes at Forensic's side. Richard Tantrum, trying to find this one loose. That Forensic knocks it there. Axe there, fans on it. Goes off Test. Test there, bringing this one back from Miami. Time is ticking. Time is not an ally of the Champaign here tonight. A Forensic, they're trying to pick it up with a buck 45 to go here in the series. Axe top side, off the back end. Stopped there by Test. Looking to find his fortune near side. Made over to Forensic, over to Zach. Zach here polling. Near side goes off the stick of Kevin. Axe trying to find the shot lane to open up. Test there staying on the angle all the way through. Kevin, great stick check. Hits the post, and that one goes far off the far side. Test to Zach. Zach near side off the wall finds Richard. Richard pulling topside finds Axe at the point. Shot made, scoring top shelf, and it's 3-4. 11 shots deep into the night, and the Champaign able to find a way to tip that one and get the scales leaning back more level. 1:20 to go here in the third. Plenty of time left for Slapshot to be had. Kevin looking down low, knocking it loose. A Forensic hitting the hand on that one. Test goes off at Forensic. Kevin there, force that one back down onto the far side corner of the Champaign zone. Richard, Axe, not able to take it in strike and knock it loose to the near side wall. 60 seconds to go in the Champaign season, unless they can find one, if not two. Zach, off the back end, splits the D, goes off Kevin's face. A Forensic here looks for the centering feed, not able to get the puck to work with him. Kevin, one man to pass to towards that near side, finds his way to Richard. Pass over to Axe. Axe, off the back end, scoring, and he finds a way to tie it. Oh, there's a chance in the air. And he's dancing like he just don't care, sporting the Discord jersey. He's able to dead knot it at fours on the board with 40 seconds to go here in the third and final period. Hits the post from Forensic in the neutral zone. It's anybody's game now. Going off the back, or the forehand pass by Kevin, 30 seconds remain. Richard looking towards that top side of the ice. Somebody will have to score to end this game. Forensic going off Axe in the corner. Finding his way topside, Kevin here with it now. Sending this one back over to Richard. Richard, Kevin, from his face to his curve. Not able to find that one on the blade cleanly before Test with the challenge. 10 seconds remain. Champaign just looking to hold on to it, looking to kill this momentum and taking it to overtime. Will he be able to? One last drive. Zach Forensic off the body. Kevin shooting! Far side and wide. And we have overtime yet again here tonight. 4-4 on the board. The crowd's electric. Paid for the whole seat. You only need the edge. The puck's dropped. The game is on. And time once again, for the last time, possibly this season, is underway. Axe going back out to the red line. Axe not giving him an angle to work with there as that Forensic there knocks it loose back into the Champaign favor. Here's Richard Tantrum going off the hands of Axe and northways for the Champaign. Zach back at his own end wall. Finds that Forensic back down defensively. Here's Zach with it yet again. Zach here for the Miami Vice Academy, leading pass for his captain. Shooting, far side post, out to the point. Tess going to throw it back, and that's going to go in. Oh! The bag of unfortunacy landing in the Miami cage. And that's just going to be a stinger. We have game three. The Champaign will not pass that one up, nor will they have to. That's a punch in the gut right there. Man, Champaign played a fabulous game. Had the pressure applied all the way in the offensive zone. 15 shots on goal with an extra 30 for a total of 45 shot attempts, according to the stat lines. Miami Vice saving all but five. Champaign using their full roster for that game. 15 shots on the pile. 8 of them coming from Trudoxity, putting the pressure on, building the momentum with every shot taken. Axe with a hat trick and the golden goal. Technically, Kevin with one, Trudoxity with the other. On the other side of the ice, 2 for Forensic, 2 for Zach. And 8 of the team's 10 saves from Zach's stick. Hopefully soon we'll get the blocks on screen as well. That's not this broadcast, that's a later problem. The Champaign taking an extra moment to try and figure out a little bit of their ping. These servers have not been kind to them here tonight by any stretch of the imagination. But 6R ready to rock, 6R ready to roll. The team that won it for the Champaign still out there on the lineup here for the first period. Ready to go here in game 3. Down on the ice at the Academy. The Champaign defend the left cage in the green. The Miami Vice Academy defend right in the black. Zach. Gonna break this one out and around town. Good stop there by Kevin, launching that one down towards that near side corner. Antrim picking it up. Finding its way out to Kevin. Kevin back to Richard. Richard looking for that far side pass over to Kevin. Kevin with a shot goes wide off the far side of the Miami cage. And Frenzik there trying to pick up the loose pieces, getting this jigsaw puzzle out. But Kevin keeps it in. Good shot and a great goal. Able to strike first with 30 seconds elapsing off this first period clock of game three. Kevin able to find a way to net that one into the back of the net ski. He does have glasses on. Look at him go. He's got the gamer glasses. The deal with it. Shades, if you will. What I don't know what it's actually called in the game. I have no idea. If it's not deal with it, it should be. Because that's the reference I recognize. Good try there by Tess. Just wide. Goes over to Zach with a hefty pass. Might have been on target. Stopped there by Zach regardless. We're finding its way towards that frenzy. Test. Off this near side wall, pinched off the hip of F. Frenzik, back over to Richard Tantrum. Top side, out of the reach there of Axe, goes all the way down the 200-foot of ice. Zach to Test. Looks for the leading pass near side. Zach, the first man to it, going to take this back down and around town. Corner to corner to Test. Back to Zach, near side corner. Excuse me. Back from the blue, the red, the blue. Shot made, nice stop there off the top side post. Richard there standing tall back between his pipes, as we know him to do. Axe there trying to pick up the mail, trying to get it delivered down against the topside point. Test takes it away. Good stop there by Kevin on the cross-ice pass. Here's Richard Tantrum with it now. Near side over to Axe. Axe polling, shooting, goes off Zach back towards the Champaign end. 3:19 to go here. One team able to crack open the goal column so far. Axe down low. Richard, just out of his reach, has to trail after it. Frenzik there trying to cut him in the corner. Not able to cut him off in time. Richard, topside, out of the reach of Axe. Zach there has to battle against him for puck possession. He's going to launch that one back down defensively. Here's the captain for the Miami Vice Academy, Frenzik. Taking that one towards that topside wall. Test. Going off Axe. Test with it yet again. There's one man to pass it to. That's the near side corner. Not able to hit him. Richard there with a great shot. Blocked away there by Frenzik. Axe topside from the blue line. Going to throw that one downtown. Here's Zach with it now. Has either option to go with. Richard getting a hand on that one in the neutral zone. Frenzik. Not giving him anything easy. Here's Zach. Kevin with a great shot. Goes off the hands of Zach. Zach here taking advantage towards that near side. Almost able to set up his captain for a one-timer. Off that near side in the lower slot. Zach with another great takeaway. Kevin there finds the puck. Nice shot. Goes off the body of Teston wide of the cage. So he throws that one back out in front of his own net. But that one's not able to be taken advantage of by Axe. Not enough time given. Axe off the tip of his blade instead of the curve. Goes over to the hands of Zach. Zach near side. Goes off the test. Test with 2:10 to go here in the first. Forehand pass near side over to Frenzik. Able to lead that one to Zach. Zach polling, shooting. What a save by Richard. Able to get it out of the zone as well. Test. Trying to get this one around the parking lot. Trying to find himself a spot to Frenzik. Shooting, scoring. And they find themselves on the board to tie us before we go into this first intermission with a little bit of pizzazz. The adversity is tremendous. They're not known to shy away from it. 1-1 on the board, 1:52 to go. First period of action is long from gone. Kevin is waiting. Taking his time, letting the nerves cool down, letting the momentum die. Steps topside, Zach takes it away. Zach off Axe, goes off Test. Axe again, goes off Zach. Towards that near side of Frenzik. Zach, or Axe wins that one away, back over to Richard. Richard to Axe. Axe off Kevin, towards the cage, it'll be on. And that lead, as easy as it was squandered, it easily came back. Kevin, able to find that one on target, the little shuffleboard push that my grandpa is known to do, his signature move. To shove it that way. 1:20 to go here in the first. Champaign on top by 1-2-1. Try there by the Miami onslaught. Richard here takes it away, goes off, Test over to Axe. Axe there with a leading pass, hooks that one a little bit too hard, would have been on target though. Good stop there by Zach at the hash marks. Axe to the point. Frenzik takes it away. Backhand shot for Miami. Going not even meeting the goal line. Wide far side either way. 60 seconds to go. Here's Test at the point. Trying to bring it around towards that top side. Cuts it through the defense. Frenzik with a shot. What a pass. Oh, what a dime to be delivered. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. And what a great shot to end it off. 2-2 on the board. The Vice Academy showing us what they've got, and I'm liking it. Best goal I've seen so far here tonight. Forensic, they're lobbing it down low. Here's Richard, banks it off the glass. Kevin gets this one down the full 200. Plays the physical game, test there, knocks it back into the neutral zone, looks near side for the shot attempt. Richard there, cutting it off every stride, every step of the way. 33 and taking here in the first. Tied at twos. Zach here with possession for Miami. Zach looks near side, Axler wins it away off the back end, fed to the point. Here's Kevin. Kevin with a pass towards Axe, not able to find him for a one-timer. Zach there sends it to the top side wall. Richard looking down low, looking to apply that pressure, looking to get this pass out in front. A forehand shot, nice stick check by Zach. That puck still bobbles around towards that topside point. Richard with the back pass. Here's Kevin. Kevin pulling, shooting off Axe's face into the near side wall. Axe over the backhand hook goes wide as well. Kevin not able to center it, and that'll be the end of the first. 2-2 on the board. The Vice Academy, the Champaign, neither team able to find themselves on top at the end of the first 5 minutes of play. Three shots for the Vice, two shots for the Champaign. Both goaltenders kind of crying a little bit. As defensive-minded as this whole series has been, this third game, not so much. One save for the Champaign, that being from Richard. No saves for the Vice Academy, that being nobody. Both teams finding themselves two goals. There hasn't been much need, not much cause, much drive, much emotion from the defensive sides of the ice. And, I don't feel like there's much to dissect from that last period. Block shots about on par. Possession time a little bit above average. They're leaving each other alone with the puck more, which is as evident as their passing game. A little bit lower. They're holding on to the puck a little bit longer, trying to find those shots on target wherever they can. Same six on the ice here for the second. That started the first here in game three. Champaign defend left in the green. It's the Vice Academy on the right in the pink and black. The puck drop. The game is on, and the second period is underway. Both teams right now equal opportunity to find themselves in the Prospects Cup Finals and a chance to go up to IM for next season. Which team will it be? Zach. Going to break this one off the far side wall. Here's Tess. Backhand. Stopped there by Richard. Going to hand this one over to Forensic. Not able to take advantage of it. Good try, though. Tom goes into the corner. Richard. Kevin. Back to Richard. 4:30 to go here in the second. Richard taking his time. Looks for the topside bank pass. Goes off the wall. Axe almost able to cradle that one like a baby, but not quite able to get his hands on it. Tess near side. Finds a Forensic after the bounce. Cuts down center. Good read there by Kevin. Staying with him every stride of the way. Richard, they're taking it from his own near side corner towards the top side. Reverse down to the near side. Gets the step on the opposition. Here's Kevin shooting, scoring, and they are back in the lead. 3-2 on the board. All three shots, all three goals from Kevin here tonight ringing true for the Champaign Champaign. I'm sure we'll see much more of that. 4:09 to go here in the second. The boys play on. Test off Axe. Not able to get the backhand to release. Test taking it on the near side corner. Kevin down low. Trying to fight for his rights to party. Nobody to really pass to. Wants this near side to Axe. Just not able to get the puck on his stick to get it there. Test to a Forensic. Through Richard. Going to chuck that one towards the green cage. Both Axe and Richard playing the pick. The miscommunication there happens. Kevin leading pass. Axe. Get checked away there by Test's backhanded slap. Kevin pulling, shooting, stopped away there off the forehand of Test. Here's Zach with it now. Zach off the back end, hits Forensic on the curve of the blade. Looks towards the top side for a pass, goes off Zach's hip, shot made, nice save there by Kevin. Here's Richard, near side, Forensic takes it away. Axler plays the physical game, so does Kevin. Kevin knocking that loose towards that top side, down into the O zone. Zach the first man to it, going to keep it back on the defensive side, looking to retrieve his own puck. Someone centered by Kevin. No fruition there. Axe here with possession. Takes someone back defensively. Here's Richard. Richard near side. Finding its way towards Kevin. Forehand shooting off the near side. No, not even hitting the cage. My bad. Zach picking up. Oh, looking down the near side. Wants to get it to Test. Might have cost him, but no. He's able to stand tall back between the pipes. First save made by the Miami Vice Academy here in game three. Here's Richard. Gets past one. Pass to Axe. Not able to defend the shot lane. Zach looks top side. Let's pop it loose to Test. Test from the backhand. Pulling. Goes off Axe's backhand. Here's Zach. Zach from the blue line. Pulling. Shooting. Scoring. And he finds a way. Like a chink in the armor. to get that one through the Champaign defense. Off that near side line, he saw it all the way through. As that puck left his stick, heel to toe. Little toe drag release, 2:26 to go here in the second. Nobody with the lead yet again here in this series. Frenzik down center. Kevin finding his way off his hip. Takes possession back for the Champaign. Reverse down to the near side wall. Here's Richard. Richard leading that one over to Axe after the bank off the wall. Looking down low, here's Zach. Zach takes it away from Miami. Afrenzik pulls this one away off the near side wall. Going to dump this one down. Maybe they felt the little hiccup as well. Pest. Zach wants to bank it around. Almost wheezed on Axe. Just not quite able to get it to work with him. Shot made off the post, and in it goes. And the Miami Vice Academy, for the first time here in Game 3, find themselves on top in the goals column. 1:49 to go here in the second. 4-3 our score. The Academy on top here at Vice Stadium. Zach looks to lead this one down the near side. Takes advantage over Afrenzik. Empty cage. Takes the jive. Not able to get the shot out on target. It's barely wide off the top right 90. Afrenzik down the near side outer slot. Pass back. Will it be on? No. Plays it safe. Here's Zach. Hucks that one down the top side. Here's Kevin with an out. Kevin lobbed that one down center. Not able to find Axe with it. Here's Zach with it now. Zach getting that pick set down center. Kevin jams that one back down. If she don't hock Tua, I don't talk Tua. Great shot. 4-4 on the board. Kevin able to zing that one back down straight. Beautiful goal. Tying us back up. Here's Richard. Topside Kevin looking for that leading pass to the near side. Here's Axe with it now. Est diving down center. Shot made. Richard getting a piece of it. Nobody there with the rebound. Maybe. Here's Afrenzik. As he takes that one towards that topside. Looking for that pass back over to Test. Test with a shot goes off Richard. Here's Test looking for that bank pass. Here's Zach with it now. Near side Afrenzik. Off that forehand. Lobs it into the corner. Here's Kevin over to Axe. Axe here driving on. Backhand shooting. Wide of the cage off the far side. Rebound comes near. Afrenzik off the boards. Trying to find its way down the far side. Zach never came. Afrenzik, 30 to go. Wheeling this one back defensively for Miami. Zach, backhand, off the wall. Afrenzik at the red line, stolen by Kevin. Kevin, backhand, shot off the end glass, finding its way over to Zach at the Miami end, finding his leading pass over to Afrenzik. Afrenzik battling for it against Richard. Back over to Kevin. Kevin with 10 seconds remaining here in the second period of Game 3. Axe there, picks it up off the forehand, stepped immediately there by Zach. Going to dump this one down and let this one be bygones, be bygones. 4-4 on the board going into the second period of action. Or going into the third period of action. We're tied at fours. Champaign, Miami not able to find a victor at the end of 10 minutes. It'll be called upon for the additional five here in the last third of the match. 14 blocked shots to 10. Seems to be where this battle is won and lost here tonight. Is who can challenge the shooter faster. So not even a warrant there a save to be made. Richard, two of the team's three saves. Got two apples on the night. Kevin with all four goals for the Champaign. He's going to have to do a little bit more. Afrenzik also doing the heavy lifting for the Miami Vice Academy in terms of goal scoring. Hat trick for him here tonight. He'll need to do at least one more. Six ready to rock. Six ready to roll. We're back down on the ice here for the third and final period of the series. Of the season for one of these two teams. Only one of them gets to walk into the finals for a best of five for the Prospect Cup. The other will be getting to walk home into the next season, perhaps. I've heard rumors that the Champaign might not come back next season. It's still up in the air. Signups do go out in 2 days, Saturday. Let's get your rosters ready. Test getting this one out of the zone. Here's Richard going off Afrenzik. Afrenzik looking for a way to get this one out in front. Bank pass to himself, looking to cut this one towards that top side. Wraparound shooting, scoring. Ah, he almost had it. Obviously, that goal line angle. I don't know how much I believe the... Yeah, that's clearly over the line. Miami Vice able to find themselves on top 5-4 early on here in the third. Test takes that one back down defensively. The Vice have done the talking they need to close out this series. They just got to clutch it up on the defensive side. Close it out. Will they be able to do it? Will it be needed? Will it be required? Test. And this one down the straight. That one barely going wide off the hip of Afrenzik, getting a clip of that one on the way through. Not going to barely off kilter. Test. Through the neutral zone, backhand shot. Kevin there blocks that one away. Gets this one towards Axe. A little bit too hyper on that one. Someone goes off towards what would have been Kevin's left. Richard, topside, lost to Test. Test here getting an advantageous touch down into the corner over to Afrenzik. Afrenzik looks for the feed out towards the point. Finds his way off the boards. Now he's going to be chopped out and away by Richard. Here's Zach with an out. 3:34 to go here in the third. 11 goals into it. One separates him. Almost able to find an equalizer right from the crack of the bat. Kevin denied access there from the defense of Miami. Here's Afrenzik, 2-on-1. Axe there, back in time to disrupt that pass across the crease. Axe, challenged there by Zach. Zach wins it away towards that topside wall. Here's Test with it now, 3:14 to go in regulation. Zach takes his time. Leans topside down the straight, goes off the body of Kevin into the corner. As Kevin tries to find the way to feed this one topside over to Axe. Axe giving some elbow room, sent back over to Kevin. Kevin, bank pass towards himself. Tries to find this one off the back end. Down low. Axe out in front. Richard takes it off the face, but not able to find that one on the stick. Here's that Frenzik off the back end. To the forehand. The backhand. Drives on from the blue line. Goes topside to the point. Test with a shot. Goes off the side of the cage and wide. Kevin gets this one down low. Zach getting a piece of that one. Going to take it back defensively. Sent down the far side wall. Test here pulling it off the back end. Goes through a few bodies into the near side corner of the Champaign zone. 2 minutes, 36 seconds remaining. Miami 5, Champaign 4. Test, looking down low. Richard, left alone with the puck, back to the point. Axe here, polling, looking down low. Not able to find the centering feed. Good stop there by Test along the far side wall. Test here, looking for it again. Test there, denies. Goes off Kevin, down low, shooting. Near side and wide, barely whizzing past the near side post. Afrenzik, from his own defensive boards. Leaving that one for Zach. Goes off Richard, into the near side corner. Richard there, loosens it up for the Champaign. Here's Axe with it now. Axe, towards the near side wall, off the backhand. Zach there takes it away from the backhand, finds Afrenzik on the top side. Afrenzik dangling. Stopped there by Richard. Richard takes this one advantageously into the O zone, down beyond the enemy goal line. Finds his way to Axe on the near side wall. Zay battle it out back to the near side point. Here's Kevin at his own blue line. Kevin for the Champaign drives on. Test there takes it away. Nobody but the post to tell him no, and that does not happen. 6-4 on the board. The Vice able to find themselves on top by two here late in the third. And that might be the goal that seals the deal, that puts the final nail in the coffin, but only time will tell with a minute 43 to go. There's plenty of slap shot left to be had here tonight between these two hockey clubs. With that Afrenzik with the puck now for Miami, taking his time with it, just taking in the breeze. Zach on that topside wall, stopped there by Richard. Richard there playing with an issue and a chip on his shoulder. Kevin gets a piece, Afrenzik gets it loose. Here's Tess with it now. Nice shot on target. Richard takes it away. Forehand shooting. Hits the post. Axe there. Sweeps it. Not able to score off the far side post. They only need a crossbar for one. Here's Kevin. Stopped there by Tess on the far side faceoff circle. Back in the Miami zone. Here's Afrenzik with it now. With possession for the defensive team. Advancing. Zach to Test. Test at his own blue line. Treading that topside line. And Zach going to catch that one off his face all the way downtown. What a spot to be. And what a catch to be had right off that left earlobe. Able to put his team up 7-4. 60 seconds to go, and that comeback story just became that much more impossible here tonight. Axe out in front. Kevin there tries to drive it out towards the net. Not able to find that one to fruition. Axe to Richard. Shot made off the side of the cage and wide. Axe there trying to find that one back out topside. Here's Kevin with it now. Kevin, backhand. Shot out in front. Here's Axe. Back out to the point. Richard. Took Axe, almost able to find the direction on target. Just not quite able to make contact. Axe there, great physicality, trying to loosen this up any way, shape possible. Shot made, scoring, Richard from the point, able to make this one goal closer. Down there on the ice, they're not rolling over, they're not giving up this one without a fight. 5-7 on the board. That was a typo for the Vice score. I added one by accident, I'm not taking away. I'm right, just go back in the VOD. 23 seconds remain here in the season. Unless two more goals are scored. Richard. Looking near side off the wall. Afrenzik takes it away. Axe there gets a bobble on that one. That one's going to be cycled back for Miami to solidify this win. Zach top side. That one's going to be lofted all the way down. 6 seconds to go. One last shot for Pride. Test there with a chance. Doesn't take it. That'll be the end of the series. The Miami Vice in the Prospects Cup Finals with a 7-5 victory in Game 3. This one going all legs of the race down the straight. And my goodness, Miami played a fabulous game there in that third period. Found a way to open up the goal scoring opportunities, taking advantage. 11 shots, 7 goals. The Vice Academy getting it done. Maybe the mentorship coming out in a big way here tonight. Played a great defensive game. 24 block shots for Miami compared to the Champaign 15. One of these teams drastically had more block shots. I think throughout the entire series, Miami Vice Academy had roughly, I think it was in the 90s, was it not? I think it was in the 90s. I could be entirely wrong with that, but it was close. It was darn close. The first game they had like 34. This game they had 24. Last game, I think you were sitting at 25. I don't know. I might just be pulling that one out of thin air. That's a 3 assist. The Mary Lemieux hat trick, as some have called it. Kevin with 4 goals, leading the charge for Champaign's 5. Richard Tantrum getting that last call to arms. Had 3 of the team's 4 saves. And a good defensive effort. Good defensive effort. But one of these teams going on to play one of the Hamilton teams. This is the roster to do it. A forensic 4 goals out of his 5 shots. Zach, 2 of his 4 going in. And it's Test playing a great offensive game, playing a very physical game. I don't know how his takeaway ratio is that. I feel like he played a much more focused and controlled bump game than the opposition tonight. And by the opposition, I mean the other 5 players on the S. I feel like Test had a great bump game. Zach, I think, was the top dog in that department. Of course, I never want to play them again. I really hope they promote. That's just my selfish want. That's my selfish need. But that's neither here nor there. If this league was corrupt, the Vice Academy would not have been in prospect this season. Nor would the Champaign. I would have just pushed everybody up, except like us and the Grinders. The Hot Doggers and the Grinders. That was going to be the whole prospect division. If the league was corrupt, that's how it would have been. But here we are. But a great series from both the Champaign and the Miami Vice Academy. Champaign, every time I would meet them down at center ice, whether it was on the East or the central region, it was always a pleasure to play against them. It was always a pleasure to schedule with them. Great slapshot team, something that SPL teams should aspire to be. I don't feel like there's much more to say. I don't feel like there's more to encapsulate. Miami Vice, congratulations. We'll see what they got. Best of 5 for the Prospect Cup Final. We'll see what the Beauty Conference has in store for us. We already took down the wild card spot of the Kingston Kings. Now the Rockets look to take down what would be either the Hamilton Huskies, the 15-3 Hamilton Huskies, or the 17-1 Hamilton Boneyard Boys. It'll be one of them. We're not sure which yet. That series deadline isn't until Tuesday because we allotted the quarterfinals to go an extra 3 days just so it would be played. And so this semifinals match might not happen until this Tuesday, this upcoming Tuesday. But thank you for hanging out. Thank you for watching some Slapshot with me here tonight. It's been fun. A lot of support down there on the ice. I saw Chef Reno. Thank you for the resub. Spinach Ravioli. Thank you for gifting a sub to Blue. Blue was complaining about ads earlier on this stream. I try my hardest to make sure ads play during the downtimes, during the intermissions, during the pregame. So the pre-roll ads are off for everybody. And sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. That's all I got to say about that. And if it didn't work, let me know. Thank you, Crusade, also for the sub. Is that Crusade? Is that Crusade_RL? Is that the same guy, or is this a different Crusade? Either way, I appreciate you subbing 5 minutes ago. Hope you're having a great day. And all the big names in red up into my left, your right, Eli, Irvion, JSTronics, former league admin and lead broadcaster, Min Snoda, Gubby, former league admin, M-Dub, Unglued Snail, Manny, the guy that actually programmed the stat parser for the intermissions, Hugh Silver's up there, Laugh Track, Davo, Cheese Pup, appreciate all your continued support of SPL. A few of those names might not be up there in the sub count, but they were in SPL itself. I really want to extend that list. I feel like FSI and Lemon Bond should be up there as well. Lemon Bond has made templates of graphics that we still use today. Min has made templates of graphics we still use today. This being kind of one of them. Not many people know this. This is Min's graphic. We've kept this in SPL's rotation for a long time, and Min Snoda is the designer of it. I feel like I needed to throw that one out there. Not many people know it. That's more trivia knowledge for you whenever the next... What was the show that Cherries did? What was it called? Jeopardy. Next Jeopardy. There you go. You got some trivia knowledge now. But, yeah. Anyway, I'm going to bed. It's past my bedtime. My mom said to be in bed by 7. It's not anymore. Catch you guys around. Thank you for tuning into the SPL Network. My name is Darth Taxo. And hopefully we'll see you guys in the next broadcast. But for now, I hope you all have a great afternoon, a great evening, and a great night. Come on.